everyone. Today I bring you some new bite-sized reviews on new drugstore products. This is where I fit in 5 reviews in 10 minutes time. So they're going to be quick. So let's jump in. First one is the new Milani Make It Last Setting Powder. So this is a pressed translucent, you might say, setting powder. It appears white just to the naked eye. And when you pick it up on a brush, it looks pretty white too. A lot of this powder picks up on the brush when you dip it in. And that's something I don't love about this. Today I used it with my e.l.f. small tapered brush and I used it to set my under eye and I did feel like I was maintaining some brightness. But also I feel like a light powder like this that picks up a little too much on the brush. This is pigmented, okay? A pigmented white powder. As you put that on the under eye area, I feel like it exaggerates the texture. Also, I don't love this in the touch-up capacity because I feel like I just see it more on the skin. I probably am seeing it even more when I'm in a touch-up mode. Any day of the week, I would take Rimmel Stay Matte over this. They actually have a range of shades, and when you put your brush in, I talk about this all the time, a limited amount of product seems to come off on your brush, but that ends up being a really good thing for your skin because a limited amount goes on, but yet it has an effect, a definite mattifying effect, but you're able to control it really, really easily. So that would be my pick if I'm looking to mattify from a pressed powder. Next up, we're going to talk about one of these new Physicians Formula Butter Bronzers. They've come out with all these different varieties now. And I got the Butter Cake Bronzer because it reminded me of Shimmer Strips. It has the different colors, and I thought, well, that could be like strips of eyeshadow or highlighter. Today, I am wearing this as my bronzer and my highlight, but let's first mention that it doesn't smell like the tropical kind of very overwhelming butter bronzer scent. It really does smell more like vanilla. But also, another difference between this and regular butter bronzer is the texture. Typically with a butter bronzer, you put your brush in and you do feel like you get pigmented color, but you're not kicking up a lot of fallout. Here, this is very, very soft. You want to dab in with care. And while it does seem kind of light, I feel like I got enough of an effect from it to be pretty satisfied with the look. So you can see it going on first on the forehead. You know, you're getting that little bit of warmth there. I would say this is an overall, you know, fairly warm tone bronzer. I'm able to lightly contour the cheekbones and get a satisfying look there. One thing to think about is if your brush is touching this highlight, this is a pretty shimmery highlight here. So if you pick up some of that, you could potentially be getting a lot of shimmer in a step where maybe you don't want so much shimmer on your skin, like if you're trying to contour with this. In that case, I would try to stay confined to the top 2 shades so you're not picking up too much of this. I use this, I'm like, it's an okay product. It's cute. You know, the top looks like cake. It looks like you've got icing piped on all around the outside. Cute idea. And yes, you could make one of these strips be eyeshadow and one be like your lid pop or inner corner pop. And then I went and used this strip alone after my blush with a highlighter brush and just was able to get some really nice glow from it. As you can see, that's a very glowy powder. It's good, but I'm not like jumping up and down over it. Really, I was so impressed by just this very basic, but really nicely toned powder here from Wet n Wild. It's the Color Icon Bronzer in What Shady Beaches. And I love the way this goes on, and I really don't need the frills of the packaging and the smell, and look how much less space. It's like half as much space, you know, that it takes up. But if you're like Em, I like the idea of the strips of product and the multitasking ability. Is there anything else that you really do love that's sort of put together that way? Undone Beauty, this brand available at Ulta, does the warm-up bronzer. 2 strips of bronzer, very large. Okay, this is a much bigger pan circumference wise, so you can very easily keep your brush up there, and then 2 tones of highlight. It's very easy to separate here with these. Here, you know, they threw a strip of highlight in between among the bronzer shades, and that makes it more tricky. These are really nice textures. I love the depth of the bronzer, love the ability to use those highlights as well. So this is a little more multitasking friendly in my opinion. Let's talk a little Catrice. We know this is a brand that I love. I'm wearing their foundation today, and I wanted to explore these 5-in-a-box mini eyeshadow palettes, and these are really, really good. I'm more impressed by these than I am those larger, like, kind of cardboard style palettes. Not the bay ones. I love those. But like this Lavender Breeze palette, this didn't knock my socks off. Not every texture was amazing, and I just didn't think the whole thought behind the color scheme was that great and really that balanced. But these little guys, I have 2 of them, 100% beautiful beautiful quality in every shade, and also I really like the balance. Now, they're not incredibly unique, but if you're looking for a little affordable condensed palette, it's really good. It's right up there also with these Wet n Wild 5-pan palettes. Frankly, they're very, very similar. It might just be a matter of, you know, you like the color scheme that you see in one of the Catrice ones, or you like this better. Either way, I think they're pretty comparable. The first one that I used is the Warm Spice Look 5-pan palette. So you're getting a shimmery kind of champagne color, goldeny champagne, matte cream, matte terracotta, a shimmery bronze, and then this matte brown. And it's really all the variety you need for a warm brown look. And then the other one I got is the Soft Rose Look. And here you're getting that same kind of pattern with a kind of brighter shimmer, two mattes here, a deeper shimmer and a deep matte. So this was the one I used today, and I want you to see it going on. I started off using the rosy shade in my crease, the matte rose, and I think that's super pretty. And then I blended above it with that other soft matte shade. It's kind of like a really, really soft matte taupe. And once I got everything in place there, I started patting the other matte in this little 5-pan, the dark matte brown, in the outer corner with a flat brush, working it ever so slightly up into the crease. A really pretty shade in this palette is this deep shimmer. It's like a deep taupe, and it's so pretty. There's actually a hint of rosiness in that shade, and then also went inward with the lightest shimmer as well. And then at the end of my look, I decided to go under the eye with my darkest matte shade as well. Before completely finishing up, I used a little more of the rose, just kind of blending that around the outer corner to make it a little more prominent, but I was so pleased with how the look turned out. These remind me of the quality that's in those Bay palettes, okay? It's very consistent. Here I got two totally different color schemes, but I really like them both. And you might be curious, how does that one compare to the new Naked 3 Mini palette? They're not identical. I'm not claiming they're dupes, but if you're looking for the soft, rosy, cool-toned look, you can get kind of a similar thing going on here, I must say. Your darkest shades are really similar. Your lightest shades are kind of on point with one another. I mean, we do have a medium kind of dusty rose in both. So not a full-on dupe, but definitely some similarities. I really like these palettes. Next up, we're going to talk about a couple of lip products. e.l.f. is continually adding to its bite-size makeup family, and now they have something called Bite-Size Balm. Now, if you know about e.l.f. from its very beginnings, they had products packaged in this same exact style when the brand started, and it was like an all-over color stick. So this is making me feel a little nostalgic because, like, that's exactly what it looked like. I got this in the berry shade, go figure. It's squatty, but it is big, actually. I mean, the whole surface area here that you have to go on the lips, it feels too big for me. And this is going to cost you $4. When e.l.f. started, darn near everything was a buck. Granted, this is a nice feeling formula and I like the overall tint that I get on the lips, but come on now, e.l.f., $4 for this little stick? A lot of times I feel like their pricing is very fair for the quality that they're putting out, and it does feel nice and rich. But was lip balm ever something that really needed to be downsized? Like, lip balm is a pretty convenient size as is. Make a bite size eyeshadow palette? Sure. Make a bite-size blush and highlighter combo? Yeah, let's make it bite-size. Bite-size brow palette? Sure. Bite-size lip balm? Lip balm was already really small, and now we've just kind of made it squatty, but it's thick, and it's kind of getting to the point where I feel like I'd need a mirror to throw this on rather than it being that super casual product that I think they want it to be. So I love so many things that e.l.f. does, but this one's missing the mark for me a little bit. Again, I don't think we need to reinvent the wheel when it comes to lip balm sizing. Lastly, you guys, this is from Milani, and it's the Keep It Full Max. I already love Milani's Keep It Full plumping glosses. They're nicely cooling on the lips. They're refreshing. They really are a great drugstore alternative to Buxom. I'm not sure how majorly they're actually plumping my lips up, but they feel really nice. Now they've come out with the Keep It Full Max, and they're calling it a plumping lip lacquer. And I will say the color on this is gorgeous. The way it went on, very full color, one swipe, that's nice. The shade I have here is called 130 Situation. But this is stingy as all get out, and I don't find it pleasant. By the time you've gotten it all on your lips, you're starting to feel it setting in, and then give it another couple of minutes and you are in full-on sting mode with this stuff. And now, even as I sit here, like, I've been shooting this whole video, I've been talking a lot, but this has been stinging the entire time. I've just been ignoring it. I've had something else to think about. I've been talking about other things. Do my lips look fuller? They look nicely smoothed out. I don't know that they really look that much different than my lips typically look with a shiny gloss on top. I really like the regular Keep It Full. The Keep It Full Max is too much for me on the pain scale, and I've gotten to the point where I can handle Too Faced lip injection. I remember complaining at one point about lip injection. I'm okay with it now. I'm okay with this Buxom, this collagen-infused lip serum. I can handle that. But this, it's like, come on now. I don't need to experience that level of pain. Just my opinion, but it's like a hot, burny feeling. We got enough things in the course of a day to just have to mess with and deal with. Like, I don't need my lip product to inflict pain. Thank you guys so much for watching. I would say my number one thing by far that I mentioned today was the Catrice 5 in a Box. That's the big winner. Love these. But yeah, thanks for your time, and I'll see you again soon. Bye.